composite supply in GST means two or more taxable supplies naturally bundle in conjunction with each other, then that would be taxable on the basis of principal supply. And what is mixed supply? Two or more supply, here they have not used the term taxable supply. Two or more supply, not naturally bundled, sold under single price, then this combo would be taxable as per the highest rate. So let's take an example so that we can understand and we get a clarity. If you are undertaking transportation along with supply of goods and contract is FOR destination, so being a manufacturer, I'm offering my price CIF, cost insurance freight. Then insurance freight is being given along with the supply of goods. It's a kind of composite supply of goods. So GST rate would be applicable on the basis of principal supply, which is supply of goods. So insurance and freight will not be charged as per their GST rate. It would be charged as a package of the composite supply, which is supply of goods, principal supply. And what is mixed supply? You get one gift pack, which is containing different item at different GST rate applicable and sold under single price, which can otherwise be sold individually, but it is being sold under single price, then this is called mixed supply and taxable at the highest rate. I know this background is known to all of you. I want to do 3-4 case studies here, which is important. Let's say you are coming for repairing of your car to me. I'm a service center. You're coming to get your car repaired. For repairing of car, I am using auto components worth 8,000 rupees and my repairing services 2,000 rupees. Total combo is 10,000 rupees. 10,000 rupees. My first question to all of you, you please tell me this repairing of car which I have undertaken. I have given 8,000 rupees auto component and I have given repairing services 2,000. Is it a composite supply? You just write composite in a chat box. Composite, please tell me in a chat box. Is it composite? In a chat box, I want, is it a composite? Yes, composite, naturally bundled. No. If anyone saying mixed, they are mistaken, is composite supply. Next question, is it supply of goods or supply of services? Next question, if you go with the dominant intention test, you came to me for getting your car repaired. Your intention was not to buy auto component. It is supply of service. It is supply of service. Yes, your intention was not to buy component. Component taxable, auto component taxable at 28%. Services taxable 18%. 10,000 is a composite supply and that too for supply of service, 18% GST rate applicable. Next question, can I bifurcate? Can I bifurcate my invoicing? Auto component separately 8,000, 28% GST rate, 2,000 separately, 18% GST rate. Possible? If possible, say yes. Or if not possible, say no. Okay, in chat box, you are saying yes and no. My answer to all of you, they're the one circular got issued 8 June 2018 and which has clarified it can be bifurcated and invoiced separately. So my only answer is, when circular is there, I can really follow the circular, but following the circular, I'm diluting the concept of composite supply. And this should not be the case. I'm of the view the circular is going contrary to the concept which has been given for the composite supply. Otherwise, what is the need of this, you know, keeping composite supply? This is the point I'm making to all of you. But nevertheless, if circular is there and if it is beneficial to the taxpayer, they may follow separate invoicing. 8,000 at the rate of 28% auto component, 2,000 18%. Taking next example, for being composite supply, they said two or more taxable supply. So there has to be two or more taxable supply. But what happened if one is taxable and one is exempted? Let's say healthcare services. Inpatient, when a patient is being admitted in the hospital, he's getting healthcare services, which is exempted. And he's getting medicine also, which is chargeable to tax. But medicine is being used for the provision of healthcare services. So you can always say you are, as a patient, you are, if you are getting admitted in the hospital, your intention was not to buy medicine, just to get healthcare services. So healthcare services, including medicine, is exempted. It's exempted, whole exempted. This is called composite supply concept. Supply of AC along with installation. So AC is 40,000. Installation is 2,000. So 42,000. It would be supply of goods or supply of services? Tell me. Supply of goods or supply of services? Of course, supply of goods. Composite supply. Am I right? Yes, Sanjeev Kumar Mishra. Correctly said. Archana, correctly said. Now come to the PPT so that we can conclude this part as well. Now, this definition I've already explained to all of you, so I'm not repeating. Let's look at this slide. This is very important. Composite and mixed supply. There may be combination of goods plus goods, service plus service, or goods plus service. And for terming as a composite and mixed supply, there has to be single supply. If it is naturally bundled, then composite supply and would be taxable on the basis of principal supply. If it is not naturally bundled and sold under single price, then the highest rate of tax applicable on mixed supply. And here the dominant intention test is important. What is your intention? I discussed repairing of car, AC with installation, healthcare services, buy one, get one. And these are the relevant circular which you may run through to get the objectivity of dominant intention test. But as I said, circular number 47 dated 8 June 2018 creating confusion that bifurcation can be done and they are diluting the concept of composite supply. But if circular is giving benefit to the taxpayer can take the advantage.